JR cooked a Solution One CrossFit, and we have Carter Williams here as well, another CrossFit coach here.
And how long have you been doing CrossFit?
I've been personally doing it for my own workouts for about 2.5 years. I got certified 2 years ago, and then we opened up here about 6 months ago. Well, today we're hitting 3 rounds, 500 meter row, followed by 21 burpees, and then a 400 meter run. So really no chance to catch your breath on this one, just a lung burner and getting after it. Instructing a client is based on what their body type is. So Carter's longer, so he's gonna be able to utilize a lot more of the chain. Also, the stronger athletes, you know, we're gonna talk about the damper setting. And for the guys, I'm not gonna put them much higher than a 6, so they don't just burn out their muscular system and keep it steady. Especially here, since we're doing 3 rounds of 500, wanna make sure we keep a nice even pace. And so right here, Carter's in the catch position, just in front of his toes. I like to keep clients' spines pretty stiff, you know, so that they're going from about 1 o'clock to an 11 o'clock. That's usually how I teach it. I don't want to get them too rounded as they reach in. A lot of times people want to reach way in to get that extra chain length, which, you know, for really strong athletes is probably going to be fine, but for someone who's not quite developed, might put some stress on the vertebrae, so I like to keep them tight. Tell them to keep the arms straight, locked out, drive with the legs, keeping the core tight, leaning back a little bit as they extend, and bringing them right below the sternum is usually where I like to have them stop, and then collecting themselves in. And then on stroke rate, you know, it's all dependent. Like today we have 3 rounds of 500. So if you start out of the gate trying to set a record for your 500, you're going to fail miserably on the burpees, the run, and the rest of them. So you're going to kind of want to pace yourself a little bit. Keep your stroke rate, I don't know, mid-20s is what I'd probably say for most people. If you're a little bit shorter like me, maybe approaching 30. But just trying to manage that 500 meter row time so that you have some gas left to hit the burpees and hit the run. For the burpee, well, basically what you're looking for is chest and the hips hitting the ground. You'll see a lot of times in a games environment people are flopping around, and it's generally accepted because they're meeting the standards of the movement, but I like to be pretty strict about it so that they keep good, again, midline stability, keeping a tight core. You know, if you're pushing and it's a competition, you'll understand getting out of the realm a little bit, but for most of the clients that are just doing it as a general fitness, I try to keep pretty strict. So
how should I get down to the ground?
So starting out, you're just gonna lower your body down, make sure your hands touch the ground. You're gonna shoot your legs back into a plank. From there, you're gonna hit a push-up to the ground, make sure your hips and chest touch once you get that full length. Then you're gonna jump your feet forward to your heels, stand up, and generally what I have them do is clap behind their head. I mean, that's generally accepted standard for most of CrossFit. That way, it makes sure that they open their hips up and that they don't shortchange, get up to here, and then just drop right back into their burpee.
So fun.
Keep pushing. Okay, Carter. Finish your way.
I got an endurance background, so that one was right up my alley. Yeah. I loved every second of it.
Yeah.
But still really dang hard. You think
what's up, guys?
You might catch your breath on the 400 meter run, or at least I did out of those three elements. No, that's where I made up a lot of ground though, because JR's got me on burpees, but on that 400 meter row, I was just chipping away at him.
Yeah.
It was tough.
the hardest part was going into the workout knowing that Carter's a really strong runner. So if I was just gonna set a PR, I probably would have took it a little bit easier on the burpees. But I knew I had to get out front on the burpees because I wasn't gonna catch him on the row and I wasn't gonna catch him on the run. So I just tried to get ahead on the burpees and it worked the first round, but his long legs and running background caught up to me and I just couldn't recover, so it was tough.
You're gonna lose your lunch there for a second.
It's real close. I don't know if that's happened before one of these, but I didn't want to be the first.
Great job, guys.
You were right there the whole time.
Yeah, sure was intense, man. Good stuff.
It's awesome. It's so terrible, and then you come back and do it the next day, so that's the cool part about it.